Mr. President, this is Mrs. Riley and Coach Riley.
Hello there. Well, see you.
Very excited to be here.
Now, don't go away.
Okay, all right.
Good to see you again.
You too, yes.
Getting to be a regular visitor.
Sorry we didn't make it last year, everybody went to Hawaii.
Thank you.
Well, now we're going to go over here, because that press you just passed wanted to come in.
Coach, we'll put these right over here.
Should I let you gentlemen?
Oh, no, I think you should, Mrs. Riley, you should be in there too.
Yes.
We're very much a team, so I can't relate to that.
All right, then.
We brought you a little reading material. Little reading material, I know, you know, about another year ago.
Oh, I am, I'm going to read.
Let's go up and lay that. Got a busy day.
Maybe should act like that.
Like 7 minutes ago from where we were.
Right down sunset.
Well.
And Los Angeles went crazy for the Lakers, so you'll come back to one.
I got to watch a little bit.
Michael, not the last 4 or 5 minutes of 6 or 7. I mean, I was thinking of nightmares. Well, I would like to present you with, I know you wear this tonight, the bed, you know, it's a nightshirt. This was autographed by the Lakers, the first team in 20 years. They go back to back and, when you're on the ranch.
Thank you very much.
And goes over this the 85 t-shirt.
Because we know that your administration is going to go back to back with Mr. Bush too, so we won back to back titles.
Well, that's
good. I don't think I should do this. I probably should not show this cover. But this is a book about last year's team that we wrote. And it definitely will put you to sleep.
It's about now. I look forward to reading.
Making history, which is something you've done in the past 8 years.
Would be a time for me to get my athletic days. I played some high school basketball, track, I was a swimmer. I got down to college. Now they're down in Minnesota.
Sure.
Well, that was the era of Indiana. It was the soul of basketball.
Still
Southern Illinois, some of it lapped over. Well, football ended and basketball started, and I went out to look at the floor with the guys that were out there on the floor, and I took one look at what they were doing. Not me. They were all those Southern kids. Illinois guys that played high school schedules of 40 games and no football. Well, we have a few souvenirs. That's cufflinks. And this is a Nancy Reagan key ring.
Oh, thank you so much.
And I know you've got somebody at home.
I do.
And in here is a glass jar with the seal on it and filled with jelly beans.
Oh. He loves his sweets too. Oh, and our little James will love this also. Thank you so much. This is just a pleasure.
Yeah, it's great.
Well, to see you again. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And I look forward to working with Nancy in our anti-drug work. We really do a lot of that
The Lakers. That's great.
So we brought her a few
wait
things.
She finds out that. That's great.
We brought our video. We made a rap song about just saying no to drugs. The big production with Magic Johnson and Kareem and everything. It really went over very well. You know, a lot of the kids in Inglewood have it, watch it, and it's made a profound impact.
Went to 8,000 schools in California all for free, so we're committed to a drug-free America, too. So I know that was on your calendar this morning, right?
Sure. We're launching the Priest campaign.
Oh, here. We're in the same band.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you so much. A pleasure.
A good day.
Thank you.
Okay. We'll see you next year. All right.
Yeah, Sunset Boulevard, huh?
Anyone ever done it 3 times in a row?
Our motto is not repeat, it's called three-peat. Three peep, that's going to be the last
time. It's a new word.
You might be there to watch.
Yes, all right.
Oh, you are. Have a good day.
This is my daughter, Cassie.
Hello there. Nice to meet you.
I'm Danny.
Hi, how are you?
Mr. President?
Yes.
Very pleased to meet you.
Very pleased to meet you.
Thank you, sir.
I think we ought to get the ladies in the middle or something.
All right.
Family photo. And I'll barge into.
Okay. All right. We'd like to have you in this, Mr. President.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, we're going to miss you.
Well, I certainly have. It's been a real pleasure to work for you these 7.5 years. And
you've made our family proud to be Americans, Mr. President, and we thank you for that.
Well, bless you for saying that. I appreciate that. Listen, I have just a few souvenirs here.
Oh, wow.
Go away and hand it.
There's quite an armload up there.
That's for you and your husband.
Well,
don't drop any glasses. And this little souvenir.
Thank you very much.
You have reverse on that.
Have I reversed on
that?
You've got a key ring.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
And you share the glasses.
Thank you, sir. We will.
All right. And then this is just a little something that's been around that we thought you might like to have.
Well, thank you very much. Right. I'll be around until the end of the summer, so I will be at the convention. And my husband leaves on Saturday, so
well,
we're going to be separated for a few weeks.
Well, don't make it too long.
No, okay. We certainly won't. Thank you, sir.
Well, listen.
It's our pleasure.
Well, good to see you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for taking the time.
Well,
thank
pleased
you.
To. Right.
Bye-bye. We'll see you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
The college, Teresa Anderson.
Well, hello there.
Robert.
All right.
Robert Dolak.
Hi, how are you?
Pleasure and honor to meet you, sir.
Amy Feit.
Hello.
Hi.
See you.
David Poe.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Hello there.
Shelly Taylor.
Honored to meet you, sir.
And Mr. Rolf Kraft, who's the director of the program.
Well, hi, how are you? Well,
yeah,
I think we'll
room
have
photo.
A good picture here.
Step down to the other side of the president there. Three on one side and three on the other.
All right.
Okay, ready to meet. Do you want to get in a little bit tighter?
Thank you, sir.
Well, how is life beneath the elms upon the campus?
Hot. Hot and dry.
Well, yes, I've gone the other way, too.
Yes, definitely.
There. One thing I never, well, I haven't forgotten anything about Eureka, but one thing I always remember in the spring was that there would pretty soon, from the surrounding neighborhood and all, there would be just that beautiful fragrance of lilacs.
Still there.
Yes, we took a bunch of pictures this spring with all the bushes in bloom. It was marvelous.
Beautiful campus.
Well, whereabouts are you all from?
I'm from Mount Vernon, Missouri. It's between Missouri. Springfield and Chapman.
Bellevue, Kentucky. It's near Cincinnati, Ohio.
Santa Rodriguez reaching out there.
I'm from Illinois. Mattoon, Illinois.
Mattoon, yeah.
I'm from McLeod, Oklahoma. It's in Oklahoma City.
Well,
and I'm from Williamsville, a small town by Springfield, Illinois.
Well, by golly, that's... I don't recall that we reached out that far.
Well, I think you've helped the college reach out quite a bit, Mr. President.
Well, pleased if I have.
This year, the semifinalists for the competition, we had 87 on campus, and they came from, I believe it was 17 different states. So and many of them, and I think this is what's most interesting, in addition to the scholarship winners for this coming year, almost a third of all those who are on campus are going to be enrolling in Eureka College. So we're really putting together a core of future leaders out there.
Well, I have to tell you, if I had to do over again, I'd go right back there at the same place. Now that I've been on the board of regents of the giant University of California when I was governor, and do things like that. And no, I would not choose one of those assembly line diploma mills. I think that's just wonderful. You'll find it sticks with you for a long time.
We hope so. It's a good place.
Are you all still there, or are you seniors?
We'll be sophomores in the fall.
You'll be sop?
No, it's just a young group.
Well, you're just coming in, not going out. I've worried a little. I haven't heard from President Hearn for a long time.
We'll make sure that...
My last letter to him, I've worried that maybe I turned off. He'd written me about some funds for kind of a museum that they...
Oh, yes.
And maybe he misunderstood my answer. I thought that duty... I know we had always lived in genteel poverty there. I thought I ought to clear the decks and tell him that if the money could be used for better, for other things in Eureka to help out. And
well, I don't think that's a problem.
It isn't.
No.
He's just busy.
And I remember when we reported your letter to the faculty, you know, and it was very clearly stated that, you know, this was a very positive step for you, and Eureka was not at all offended by this in any way, shape, or form.
Okay.
But I'll make sure you get a letter. In fact, I think you'll probably get 6 or 7 letters.
I'm saving up things that I think would fit in that museum. Wherever it is. You'll do that. Well, incidentally, you should have some souvenirs of your visit here. These are all key rings with the presidential seal on them.
Thank
one
you.
Day you'll be having need for keys.
Thank you very much.
We also, and we are parents, we have a new T-shirt with us. But then it was suggested that we probably should not bring it in at this visit. We would like to ensure that you got that, though.
Well, fine.
Should we just send it to the White House? Is that the correct
order? All right, fine. Yes.
They all have their Eureka T-shirts, and we want to make sure that all 7 of us here today have those.
I remember our wardrobe used to be just a sweatshirt and worn as a T-shirt. And then you were a letterman, and I was one with your letter sweater over it. And washing dishes in the girls' dormitory, and as wood. And we always dined in the dining room, and one day Lydia Wampler suggested that she thought it would be nice, since we dined in there with the girls, that we would wear neckties. And she just specified neckties. It meant a great change of wardrobe for us if we obeyed what she really meant. So I talked to the other fellas. And we just came in with the sweatshirts on and with those little elastic band bolts on our bare necks. And I guess she figured that she was defeated, and so
are you living in light of what's on now?
I am. It's beautiful. It's very nice.
Yeah, renovated last year. Beautiful structure.
I'm washing dishes in the commons
now. It's close.
Well, I've used that experience of where I wash dishes to lots of times in talking to young people and so forth on campuses, and I've told them that one of the better, I worked my way through college, that one of the better jobs I've ever had was washing dishes in the girls' dormitory. Let them read into it what they will.
We thank you not only for what you give to college, but for being a great president for these 8 years.
For thank you.
The entire community, and I think the whole Eureka community is just so proud. That,
bless you, thank you. And I better not go back there.
That's right. You know, and I'm not sure. Everyone, I'm relatively new. I'm the freshman of the group. I've only been there a few months. And I'm really amazed that even 40-year-old people seem to have known you in college, which I...
That was easy, right?
Mr. President, how are you? President, this is Christopher Bree.
Hello there.
Very nice to meet you.
All right.
Laura Bree. Jessica Breed.
Hello.
Sally Townsley.
Hello there.
Joe Townsley.
Hello. Nice to see you.
Jim Townsley.
Hello there.
Bunch of these guys. Michelle Townsley.
Hello.
Jennifer Townsley.
Jennifer.
Oh, whoops. There we go.
All right.
How are you, Mr. President? Good to see you again.
Vice President.
Right. 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 You.
Adam Hansen, President.
President?
Hello there.
Okay, Mark. Now I'll press.
Okay. President, this is Shelley Breed, who is the Mother of the Year.
Hello there. Well, I have to bring this little bit so that you can...
Yes.
People. Nice to see you. Congratulations.
Nice to see you.
And Don Towsley, the Father of the Year.
All right. Let's angle this one a little bit, too.
Okay. Daniel Travanti, the National Campaign Chairman this year.
Mr. President.
Frank Horton.
Hi. Mr. President, good to see you again.
Good to see you.
This lady over here is from my district out in Ontario, New York, up near Rochester.
Well,
and you were not too far from there. Remember when you were up in Clyde, New York?
Okay, going on. Mr. Fun. We figured
that one of the sweetest things you can give any actor is the Oscar. So this is thanks to Eastern Airlines, who rushed it down from New York City and Cake Masters. But we felt you deserved this all on your own, and we want to give it to you on behalf of the National Multiple Sclerosis Foundation. Thank you for helping us.
Well, I never got an Oscar. But I didn't know when I finally did get one, I could eat it.
We thought you might want to share it with the kids so they don't act up. I asked them if they were going to behave in here. I told them I wasn't going to. And we know that you're a kid or two, so.
Well, that's beautiful.
We thank you from the bottom of our hearts for helping all people with multiple sclerosis.
Well, listen, to the society, I know the work that it is doing, they're all doing, and I think it's wonderful, and particularly with regard to the work that is being done toward finding a cure and development of that kind. And I'm very proud to have the Mother of the Year and the Father of the Year here, and I know that you do more than just accept that honor. I know that you're very active and you do a lot of counseling with children other than your own. And I know that you are very much with the Cub Scouts in your area, among other things. Well, I'm just proud that you're all here. Couldn't be happier. I see there's quite a group over there.
We're going to do a little bit of a family pictures, too.
Thank you, John.
Right.
Thank you.
Okay. Right. Now we're going to switch families.
It's a very unusual Army Air Corps. I was a reserve officer called to active duty. But I was a reserve officer in the horse cavalry, and I wanted to have the Air Force.
Okay.
He's been up to one thing. He didn't call him.
Yeah.
She's not.